Good evening, everyone, and thank you for joining us this evening. I am calling to order this hybrid council meeting of Monday, June 27th, 2022, to order. Please be advised that this meeting is being broadcasted and recorded by Hartford Public Access Television and can be viewed via the Hartford Public Access TV Facebook page, Compax Xfinity Channel 96, www.hpatv.org, or Channel 6032 for Frontier customers. Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Here.
Councilwoman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Here.
Councilman Mitchell.
Here.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Present.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Here.
Councilman Sanchez.
Present.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Here.
We have a quorum, Madam President.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. And now if we could please join me in the Pledge of Allegiance. So this evening, we have a point of privilege. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. So this evening, it's my extreme pleasure to present a proclamation from the Mayor and the Court of Common Council members of the Corona family, you guys want to come on up here? So we've got James Corona and his son Jonathan Corona. And a little background. Over the years, it's been my extreme pleasure to do business with Hartford businesses. And one of the businesses that I started doing business with when I was a very young guy, running around with a Volkswagen that always needed parts, was going down to Corona's. In fact, I used to go down there with my father, who at the time we used to be allowed to go into the junkyard with our screwdriver and our wrench, and we would pull a taillight out ourselves or whatever. But at some point in time, I also realized that there were a lot of businesses in Hartford that were fathers and sons. And so tonight, I want to give a proclamation to one of our Hartford businesses that's representative of fathers and sons doing business here in the city of Hartford. And so we've got this proclamation for you two Coronas tonight with a little history written right into it. So we've got, whereas Vincenzo V.J. Corona was born in 1914, the oldest of six brothers. The family lived on Mechanic Street. For you history buffs, find Mechanic Street in Hartford. In what was then the East Side, VJ and his brother Dominic started collecting old appliances and other items using a hand-pushed cart, and they brought them to Mr. Katz for recycling. In 1937, Mr. Katz helped VJ buy land on Windsor Street so he could expand his recycling. By 1950, after service in both World War II and Korea for one of the brothers, all of the brothers had joined in the business. From recycling rags, newspapers, and metals, they grew to salvaging old cars. They outgrew Windsor Street, and they purchased 608 Weathersfield Avenue, which was many, many acres extending down to Locust Street. There were so many cars being junked at that time that by the late 1950s into the 1960s, they purchased land at the corner of Wawarmey and Weathersfield Avenue, and later, they had a lot in the North Meadows off Jennings Road. Ultimately, the city took Wawarmey, and you will all know it now as Buckley High. VJ was now doing business as Corona Auto Parts, Inc., bought more land between Weathersfield Avenue and Locust Street. He sold off the North Meadows land and consolidated their five operations in the South End. towing, auto repair, body work, auto parts, and auto recycling. VJ's sons, Patrick and James, who is here with us, worked the business with their father since birth. And Patrick would have been with us tonight, I understand, but he's a little under the weather. Yes. By 1971, Patrick and James were working full-time. As the years passed, some of VJ's brothers moved on to other businesses, some retired from Corona's, eventually leaving only VJ, his wife Mary, and the boys. Pat and Jim were soon joined by Arnie Mason, who had married their sister, Janice. VJ worked 7 days a week most of his life, slowing down to 6 days a week in his later years. The day he died at age 93, he dressed for work and never made it. The three amigos, Pat, Jim, and Arnie, carry on and are now working on bringing in a third generation to the business, Jonathan here. Therefore, be it proclaimed that Luke Bronin, as the mayor of the city of Hartford, along with the Court of Common Council represented here tonight and the entire city of Hartford, do hereby recognize and express our gratitude to VJ Corona and his sons, Pat, Jimmy, and son-in-law, Arnie, as dedicated small business owners in Hartford, quietly and competently providing everyday services to our city and beyond for over 85 years.
Thank you very much.
Congratulations.
It's an honor to accept this from the city.
Congratulations.
Would you like to say anything?
Well, it's been a pleasure serving the city of Hartford. Every day, it's a family operation, and all of our employees, 18 of us, act like we're all family anyways, and most of them have been here over 20 years with us. It's absolutely a high to go to work every day and service the people in Hartford and surrounding towns. And I accept this and I thank you very much.
You're very welcome. Thank you both again.
Thank you. Thank you, Councilman Gale. That was great. And now, Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. I make a motion to approve the minutes of the June 13th, 2022 Council meeting.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions on the minutes? Any discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchum.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. I make a motion to place the following items on the consent calendar. Item 4.1, Public Works, Parks, Recreation, and the Environment Committee with the accompanying resolution supporting the Park River and its tributaries. Item 4.2, Operations Management, Budget, and Government Accountability Committee with accompanying resolution creating a microgrant program for Hartford residents seeking to launch a small business in the city. Agenda item 4.5, Operations Management and Budget and Government Accountability Committee, with accompanying resolution authorizing a budget increase for the school building project currently underway at Burns Elementary. Agenda item 4.8, Operations Management, Budget and Government Accountability Committee, with an accompanying resolution authorizing the transfer to the suspense book of $5,242,382.22. Resolution 4.12, Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee, with accompanying resolution authorizing the mayor to accept a grant in the anticipated amount of and 13 cents from the State of Connecticut Department of Transportation Highway Safety Committee. Resolution 4.14, Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee, with accompanying resolution confirming the appointment of Jaquan Samuels to the Commission on Human Relations. Resolution 5.1, Councilwoman Shirley Surgeon, Majority Leader Clark, Councilman Josh Mixtum, and Councilwoman Tiana Hercules, resolution in support of the Sportsman Athletics Club to use their outdoor sound system for the 60th annual West Indian Celebration Week. Resolution 5.2, Councilwoman Shirley Surgeon, Majority Leader Clark, Councilman Josh Mixtum, Councilwoman Tiana Hercules, a resolution in support of the West Indian Social Club and the Lodge to use the outdoor sound system for the 60th anniversary West Indian Celebration Week. Is there a motion?
Second.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Councilman Mixtum?
Thank you, Council President. Just briefly on number 4.12, which is accepting a grant for traffic safety enforcement. I think it's worth mentioning we had a robust discussion in quality of life and public safety, and we all were in favor of it. But one of the things we talked about and what the chief of police told us was that we get a marginal increase in traffic safety right around the time of increased enforcement, which is of course good. But the point that came out of that, at least for me, was that This is a Band-Aid approach, and we put the Band-Aid if there's bleeding, but we need to really be thinking about spending more from year to year on our street redesigns, on our permanent environmental traffic calming. So I think we all support this, but I think we also all realize that we need to
do more cures. Thank you, Councilman Mixon. Are there any other comments or discussion? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll on the consent calendar?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mishnam.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. I make a motion to refer the following items to the Planning, Economic Development, and Housing Committee. Resolution 3.1, Mayor Bronin, with accompanying resolution authorizing the transfer of 5 city-owned properties to the Hartford Land Bank. Public hearing Monday, July 18th, 2022 at 7 p.m. with an 8:24 review. Resolution 3.2, Mayor Bronin, with accompanying resolution authorizing the city to amend and extend the lease of 40 Coventry Street for 15 years with Intercommunity Resources, Inc., with a public hearing on Monday, July 18th, 2022 at 7 p.m. with an 8:24 review. Resolution 3.3, Mayor Bronin with accompanying resolution authorizing the city to execute and deliver a lease agreement to allow the city to use the property at 23 Kelleher Court in Wethersfield.
I second the motion.
Motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Any discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchell.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
Thank you, Council President. I make a motion to, receive the following items. Resolution 3.4, Public Works, Park, Recreation, and the Environment Committee, communication concerning a resolution authorizing and empower the city to grant CNG. Resolution 3.5, Public Works, Park, Recreation, and the Environment, communication concerning update report, official process for park renovations and current park construction projects at Bushnell, Forrester, Goodwin, Colt, Elizabeth, and Keeney Parks. Resolution 3.6, Labor, Education, Workforce, and Youth Development Committee, with accompanying communication presentation from Superintendent Dr. Leslie Torres Rodriguez, Hartford Public Schools. And 3.8, resolution, Councilman Gale, an ordinance amending section 32-18 to increase the tax credit from 500 to 750.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Any discussions? Councilman Mixtum.
Thank you, Council President. Just two brief notes on item 3.4. It's listed in our agenda as just saying a resolution authorizing and empower the city to grant to Connecticut Natural Gas Corporation, but it does not say what. The resolution was to grant an easement, and I think this is, it's in the text, but just if anyone's just looking at the menu, it just says grant an easement from basically from the back of Weaver High School across under the high, under the railroad tracks, across the wetlands to University of Hartford so that they can build some kind of power substation. I don't remember the name of it. But what's notable also is that the communication says the committee is not done with this matter. There were a lot of questions. There was not a good map provided. There was not a good understanding of the environmental impacts. So this is not just going forward. The committee is still working on it. And I know a lot of people cared a lot about this. So I just want it to be out there that it's in process and it is not confirmed or denied as yet. Thank you.
Through you, Council President? It will be coming back to the Parks Committee on July 13th with the questions brought to the committee at the time and CNG, and we will decide at that time if it goes forward.
Wonderful. Duly noted, and thank you for sharing that information, Councilwoman Rossetti and Councilman Mishtam. Is there any further discussion? Any further discussion? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mishtam.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
For the record, Council President, 4.4, Operations Management Budget and Govern Accountability Committee with an accompanying resolution which would approve a tentative agreement for a successor collective bargaining agreement between the City of Hartford and the Hartford Police Union is withdrawn.
And that was stated for the record. We do not need a motion on the withdrawn item. Assistant Majority Leader Rossetti, you have the floor.
Council President, I make a motion to postpone the following items. Agenda, resolution 3.7, Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee, communication concerning facial recognition technology. Resolution 4.15, Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee, with accompanying resolution calling for the Hartford Police Department to provide the heart of the provide the Hartford Court of Common Council with an update on the climate study, item number 6.4 on the June 13th, 2022 agenda. And resolution 4.16, quality of life and public safety, with accompanying resolution calling for the Hartford Police Department to provide the Hartford Court of Common Council with a plan to address an increase in violence during the summer months.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Any discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchell.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make motion that we take action on the following item, item number 4.3, which is a resolution calling for monthly capital improvement plan reports and monthly updates on RFPs over 25,000 issued from the procurement department.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Councilman Gale.
Thank you, Madam President. I now make a motion to amend that resolution by changing one word in the resolved clause that the reports from CIP come to council quarterly. So my motion is that we strike the word monthly and in its place I include the word quarterly. And I would just note this was discussed at committee and it was agreed and the recommendation back to council was to do exactly this.
Second.
A motion has been made and probably second on the amendment. Are there any other discussions? Any other discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mishnah.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Abstain.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
So I think we just voted on the amendment, and we now need to just vote on the underlying resolution as amended.
Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll? On the original resolution.
Mm-hmm. Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchell.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
As amended, yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Abstain.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make a motion that we take action on item 4.6, which is a resolution approving the annual action plan for program year July 1, 2022 through June 30th, 2023.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Any discussions?
Madam President, I'd like to recuse myself from this vote as I am one of the organizations I am a signer for.
Duly noted. Mr. Clerk, could you, Councilman Gale?
Yes, likewise, I ma'am. Also.
Okay, point of order, Councilman Gale?
Likewise, Madam President, I will recuse myself on this vote.
Thank you. Councilman LeBron?
I believe I should be recusing myself as Catholic Charities is one of the items, I believe, if this is the right one, that's listed on here. So I have to recuse myself as well.
Duly noted. We will do the roll call. Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Point of order or a question, I guess. Do we have enough votes? Do we have a quorum now?
I believe the majority rules, although we have abstention on this.
Give us a moment, please. Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Yes, but I see Councilwoman Surgeon.
Mr. Clerk,
has her hand.
I see that Councilwoman Shirley Surgeon has her hand up.
Through you, Madam President, I didn't quite hear the response from the Corporation Counsel's office regarding the question by the councilman.
I'm sorry, Councilwoman Surgeon, I didn't have my mic on. Yes, we, depending on how the votes go, the clerk can call and there would be enough people if they vote in the affirmative to pass.
Okay, thank you, ma'am.
Mr. Clerk, could you continue with the roll call, please?
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti. Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon?
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President.
Council President?
Yes, Councilman Sanchez?
Yes, my question is that can the council, corporation council, Attorney Lombardi explain how is this rule applied?
Councilman Sanchez, just hold on a second. Can we lower the voice for Councilman Sanchez so that we can hear him, please, just a little bit? Thank you. You may proceed, Councilman Sanchez.
The abstention that we have, how is the, what's the rules here? Is it the majority of who are not abstaining?
I can't hear him. You're not coming in clear.
It did pass, right? Yes, present and voting four,
okay.
Four, three.
I don't know if you can hear me, but the motion that we just took a roll call passed for present and voting. Councilwoman Rossetti, Councilman LeBron, and Councilman
yes.
Gale had to recuse themselves.
Right, I understand that. So my question is, what rule applies here when three members abstain? Is it the majority of the vote from the remaining members? How does the rule apply when three members abstain?
If you can give Attorney Lombardi a minute, she's trying to look for the ruling. Thank you. So, Councilman Sanchez, we're just validating the rule, but usually is present and voting. But we're going to move on to the other items while Corporation Counsel Lombardi verifies that information. Thank you. Councilman
Thank you,
Gale,
Council,
you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I'd like to make a motion that the council take action on item 4.7, which is a resolution authorizing submission to the Connecticut Department of Revenue Services of a list of community programs eligible for the 2022 Connecticut Neighborhood Assistance Act Tax Credit Program.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Any discussions? Councilwoman
Rossetti? Through you, Council President. Again, I need to recuse myself as I am a signer on the NAA tax application.
Duly noted. Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Yes.
Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mishnah.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Recuse.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make a motion that council take action on item 4.9, which is general fund ordinance, making a general fund appropriation to reflect project costs relative to public improvements at the McDonough Middle School.
Second.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there? Councilman Gale.
Just by way of explanation, the ordinance that we're going to vote on has been changed by eliminating certain language in section one. The language was extraneous and it's been ruled by Corp Counsel. I understand that it's a non-substantive change. So you have the substitute ordinance in your package, but I just wanted to note the reason for taking action on this is the elimination of the last clause in section one, which was an inappropriate dollar amount of project costs that there were no relationship to the actual ordinance. Thank you.
Do I have a second? Is there a second?
I had seconded, Madam okay. President.
A motion has been made and properly seconded. Are there any discussions? Discussions. Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mishnah.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. And now we're back to the original motion. Mr. Clerk, if you could please call the roll.
Sorry.
That was a roll call on the
on the amendment, right? Yeah, that was the roll call on the amendment. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make a motion that we take action on item 4.11, which is an ordinance making general fund appropriations to reflect project costs relative to public improvements at the Parkville Community School.
A second.
A motion has been made and properly seconded. Are there any discussions? Councilman Gale.
Again, Madam President, similar to the last ordinance that we just voted on, we had and your packet includes a substitute ordinance, and that's what we're going to vote on. But just by way of explanation, the substitute has the same change in section one. There's an elimination of the last clause, which was extraneous and deemed inappropriate. And again, my understanding from Corp Counsel is that it's not a substantive change.
Thank you for that clarification, Councilman Gale. Are there any other discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Yes.
Councilwoman Hercules? Councilman LeBron?
Yes.
Councilman Mishnah?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rosado?
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti?
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez?
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon?
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make a motion to take action on item 4.11. I'm sorry. We just did 4.11, huh? 4.10. I took them out of order. My apologies. So now we're going to do 4.10.
Okay.
Which is a ordinance making general fund appropriations to reflect project costs relative to public improvements in the Expeditionary Learning Academy at Moylan School.
Second.
Motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Councilman Gale.
Again, Madam President, just to note, same as with the Parkville School and the McDonough School, we have a substitute ordinance where the last clause of Section 1 has been taken out. They were all similar clauses, and now they're all similarly stricken.
Thank you for that clarification. Are there any further discussions? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchum.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilwoman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
Thank you, Madam President. I make a motion that we take action on item 4.13, which is resolution to request the police chief to begin a search and select a candidate for the vacant position of assistant police chief.
Second the motion.
A motion has been made and properly second. Are there any discussions? Councilman Mixon.
Thank you, Madam President. Just briefly, I will vote no on this because, as I have said many times before, the city spends way too much on police. It keeps us from spending money on all the other things we need to spend money on because we don't have money left over. So I'm not going to be on board for urging hiring of one single more police officer.
Thank you, Councilman Mixon. Are there any other Councilman Sanchez?
Yes, I appreciate that, and through you, Madam President. So I appreciate that, Councilman Mixon, but as I've always stated that, and my constituents and all of our constituents always been reaching out to all of us, and I think it's important that we make sure that the police department is fully staffed, especially with the higher staffing leadership. And it's important that, especially in today's day and age, what's going on with the shootings, the homicides, we are in dire straits in need of filling those positions now so that it's more feasible and more accountable to what's going on within the city. Everyone that I've spoken to, my neighbors, my family, we've discussed this before, they want more protection. There's no way they will say no to not having more officers in the city. So I respectfully request that, or at least advise everyone, vote in favor of this resolution. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Sanchez. Councilwoman Surgeon.
Thank you, Madam Chair. I also, Councilman, will be voting no on this resolution. And the reason I'm voting no on the resolution is we vote to hire a police chief. And the police chief basically is the one who will put together his administration and his control staff. So I don't believe that council should be, we can urge him, and work with him. I do believe that the city and the residents are looking for more protection, but I am of the thought that I have very much have given my vote to hire a police chief, and I would like him to do his job. And if he needs another person in his administration, he's the one who makes that decision. Once we as council has decided to hire someone, I always believe I leave it up to the administration and to the person that we hire to do the best they can in the running of their department. So I don't feel that as a council person setting policy, this is a policy which I don't want to set to tell the police chief, how to run his department. So I'll be voting no on that.
Councilman Sanchez.
So, Appreciate that, Councilwoman Sargent, but this resolution is not to take away the authority of the police chief and do his due diligence in hiring. This resolution is just requesting that he starts the process in hiring that assistant police chief position that assistant police assistant chief Medina has vacated. I think it's important that Chief Doty has all the support possible to run the department, and we are in a situation right now where the homicides are up, the shootings are out of control, and I believe that it would be very advisable that he does start seeking out for this next new assistant chief for the position for operations so that it can alleviate the rest of the staff so that they can do their job, but also support the chief himself. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Sanchez. Are there any other further discussions? Councilman Mixtum.
Thank you, Madam President. Sorry to belabor the point, but briefly, we should note, and I say this based on what the chief told us at the last Quality of Life and Public Safety Committee meeting, homicides are up 1 year to date over last year, dramatically down from, say, 10 or 20 years ago, essentially statistically even. Non-fatal shootings are down year to date compared to last year. That doesn't mean things are rosy in our city in terms of crime, but let us say the thing as it is and make our decision accordingly.
Is there any further discussion? There be
yes.
Oh, Councilman Sanchez.
Yes, I appreciate that. Through you, Madam President, I appreciate that, Councilman Mitchum. But you know what? I think we're too dependent on this data that is collected. Years ago, maybe it was higher than what it is now, but we're talking about now. My constituents, your constituents, are extremely tired and are demanding more enforcement. We have to have a plan right now before it gets out of control. Summer just started. You know, the data that is always fed to us may not be the realistic way of what what's going on right now in today's daily life. In my opinion, we need every single possible officer without stressing them, without putting them in danger to the extreme and getting them tired to serve our community, to be the guardians of our community. It's way too many shootings, way too many homicides. We need every support that we can get, regardless of the data, so that we can have some kind of control within our city. And I'll leave it at that. Thank you.
Thank you. Is there any further discussion? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchell.
No.
Councilwoman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilwoman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
No.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. Councilman Clark. God bless him. Councilman Gale, you have the floor.
I am Councilman Clark for the evening here at the end. Thank you, Madam President. I think it's the last one. I make
yes.
a motion that we take action on item 4.17, which is the ordinance concerning the elderly tax credit.
I second the motion.
Motion has been made and properly seconded. Are there any discussions? Councilman Gale.
Thank you, Madam President. Again, just by way of explanation, first off, the ordinance itself is came out of committee We discharged it, but the ordinance itself will increase the elderly tax credit from $500 to $750. It's been sitting at $500 for over 30 years, as I understand it, and we've been given assurances that the cost to the budget has already been built into the budget, so there are no negative ramifications to the budget that we've already adopted. Second point is that When the ordinance, we made a second amendment to this ordinance already this year to increase the applicable dollar amounts for a single person and a couple, and those weren't reflected in the ordinance that went that was originally submitted to council. So you have in your packet a substitute ordinance that includes the changes. They're non-substantive. They're required because they were already passed by city council, and they just increase the dollar amounts by a couple of thousand dollars on each side. Put in as a substitute. That's it, Madam President. Thank you.
Thank you, Councilman Gale. Did I hear a second? But did we have a second? Okay,
second.
Great. Councilman Shirley Sergeant?
I think I may change my gender from female to male, the way things are going tonight. I'm confused. I thought 4-7 was on the consent calendar.
4.17 was on the consent calendar, but because it was an ordinance, we moved it to 4.17. 4.17 was moved to action. You were correct. Originally, it was on consent. But based on the comments that Councilman Gale made for clarification purposes, we put the item on action.
Okay, so in conjunction 4.9, 4.10, and 4.11, 4.17 was also moved to action.
I can't.
Can you hear me?
Councilman Gale, go ahead. I think Councilman Gale just heard what you said. You have the floor.
I'm not sure if this is responsive, Councilman Surgeon, but we were told in order to discharge this, in your reports earlier, we added 3.8, which was discharging the matter from committee, and we voted affirmative on that. Council All President right. felt that it was illogical to put 4.17 on the consent calendar before we had received it. So we took 4.17 and moved it to the end of the calendar so we could first receive it as item 3.8, and now we're voting on it. Does that explain?
Makes sense, because that was my next issue, was how could we have, you know, received 3.8 and then, so now you have clarified that for me. Thank you, sir.
Is there any further discussion? There being none, Mr. Clerk, could you please call the roll?
Councilman Clark. Councilman Gale.
Yes.
Councilwoman Hercules. Councilman LeBron.
Yes.
Councilman Mitchum.
Yes.
Councilman Rosado.
Yes.
Councilman Rossetti.
Yes.
Councilman Sanchez.
Yes.
Councilman Surgeon.
Yes.
Motion passed.
Thank you, Mr. Clerk. And now we're at the end of our agenda. Yes, Councilman Mixon.
Thank you so much. I just wanted to mention, this is not on the agenda, but on Sunday was the Domingo event, which opened up Farmington Avenue for no cars and just walking and bicycles, and there was music and lots of great things, and it was really lovely, and I just wanted to congratulate all of the city staff and folks who made it happen, and hope that people come out on the next one, which is July 24th, I believe. That is on Park Street. And it's just a ton of fun for families and kids. And I just wanted to put that out there and say thanks to everyone.
Yes, and I want to echo Councilman Mixtum's comments on that. It was very lovely. I could not attend, but received a lot of phone calls. And I believe that it was Nat Gale who came up with this idea. So Nat, thank you for that great idea. Also, tomorrow we have a committee of the whole meeting where we will be discussing the charter revision. So please join us. And Councilman LeBron has his hand up. Go ahead, Councilman LeBron.
Yeah, I know that we were waiting for the ruling from Councilman Sanchez on rather the four votes in the affirmative for that item was, I guess, legal, with three people recusing themselves and four out of nine not being a majority, or if the differentiation is that the four out of the seven be the majority of who's present. I think that
Attorney Lombardi, I'm sorry, Councilman LeBron, to interrupt you, but Attorney Lombardi is going to give us clarification on that.
Thank you very much.
Yeah. Attorney Lombardi.
Thank you, Council President. So under Robert's rules, it's a majority of those present and voting on that item. We actually had only four people vote because there were three abstentions. So obviously a majority of those voting, all four, did vote yes, and so that did pass.
Thank you very much to both of you.
Thank you. And with that said, everyone have a nice evening.
Thank you.
This meeting is adjourned.